Listen, man, it was our first trip out to Leith. We were going to North Berwick to see a boxing match. My mate, John, he's boxing. East of Scottish Championship. Fucking brilliant, we're all excited. On the bus, it was our first trip out to Leith. Whole crowd there, man. Big John's fucking Barry, he'll fucking knock that cunt out, man. First round, he's a fucking teapot, man. He's fucking Barry, he's getting that fucking toast, man. This old wifey pipes up. Excuse me? Would you mind trying to curtail your language, please? There's children on this bus. I thought I'll step in here and smooth this over before my mates rip her a new arse. I stepped in and said, I'm very sorry, old lady. I really must apologise for my friends. I'll tell them to curtail their language, which was a word I'd learned 30 seconds previous. I said, see, they were just a bit excited, man. I sort of calmed it all over, because I'm a diplomat, right? I'm not a real diplomat, with immunity and stuff, and Ferrero Rocher and all that shit, but I'm diplomatic. I went over, I thought, I've smoothed this over. Very sorry, old lady, I'll tell my friends. And it's not their fault, it's just every cunt swears where I come from. But they do. Every cunt swears in Leith. Every cunt, right? My mum and dad swear, the lollipop lady swears, the teachers swear. Every cunt swears in Leith. And it's not even an offensive word, right? Because you say, oh, I like him, he's a good cunt. Bring him along. He's a funny cunt, aye. This cunt, that cunt, every cunt, it's just another word for a person. If I was to say person all the time, then I would be a posh cunt. I'm not a posh cunt. I do get taxis everywhere I go. I mean, everywhere I go, I take a taxi. Only because I'm a taxi driver, and I find it's handy if I go to work and I've got my taxi with me. Otherwise, I'm getting folk call the buckies down the high street. You do pick up some nice people in the taxi, like. You also pick up a few rajas, eh? I picked up these three guys the other night. I mean, the only reason I picked them up is because I missed a wee button that locks them out. They've got in the taxi, the guy's wearing a suit jacket with nothing underneath it. Baseball cap, the three of them's in, it's like a scene for Trainspotting. He's pushed his baseball cap through the wee space. Alright, driver, you're going to Muirhus, by the way. And then he put your meter on, because you're not getting paid. I'm like, fucking hell. So I spun the taxi around, we're heading to Muirhus. I put the meter on anyway. Well, I figure, if you're going to get bumped, you might as well know how much it was for. But I guess the guy's down to Muirhus. I'm driving down. The guy's like, alright, driver, go buy a mobile phone, gadget. It's fucking Barry, BT, Cellnet, WAP technology. I says, oh, it's a nice phone, mate. Where did you get it? He said it was in this jacket. Property being 9/10 of the law in Muirhus, eh? Anyways, I've dropped him off. I knocked him down to 30 quid for the phone. And I got paid for the fare. 6 quid. They always pay you. He says, I'll give you a tip as well, driver. I says, oh, thanks very much. He says, didn't he put out lit fags with bare feet? I says, I'll give you a tip, mate. Aye. I says, didn't share needles, you junkie fuck.